Welcome to Beyond Tough. I am Karen Bryan alongside former UFC champion Misha Tate, reigning middleweight king. I hear he's undisputed.
I am undisputed.
Michael Bisping and this week's big winner, Sijara Eubanks, who just rolled her eyes at you, Michael.
I know.
So I already like this
for
girl.
The third time.
Right, exactly. All right, folks. Lauren joined TUF TALK last week and made no bones about how she really feels about Coach Eddie, and she actually got into it a little bit more on this week's episode, so let's take a look.
I was like in bed and Barb was like, are you going? I think you should go. I was like, no, I'm not going. I'm just gonna sleep and like cry a little bit.
I hope Eddie's not giving like some big speech at the gym about how like I should be back in there already or whatever.
If you lost and you're not here, then you're probably not built for this. So I appreciate you being here.
Well, you're here. I'm happy you're here.
Happy to be here too.
Okay, you're lost and you're not here. You're probably not built for this. I don't know. That's kind of strong words, Sijara. What do you think? Do you think Lauren should have shown up for that morning practice, or are you taking Lauren's side and saying she could have had some time off?
I'm with Eddie on that one. I think you get knocked off the horse, you got to get back on.
Hours later.
If you get knocked off the horse, you need to get back on. Yes. If at first you don't succeed, try again. These are lessons for life, but they don't apply in the Ultimate Fighter. When you get knocked off that horse, you are knocked out of the competition. Therefore, I say you're allowed to lie in bed, lick your wounds, have a fatty breakfast. And the fact that she went to the afternoon session, good for her. I wouldn't have gone anywhere near that gym for a couple of weeks.
I mean, a couple of weeks is a long time to sit around by yourself in the house. I think it stemmed more from the fact that she didn't like Eddie. I think that had a lot to do with it. I do. I think if she was in a different environment, she was at home. Like, even back home, I might not show. I mean, I'll come in the next day and sit on the side with ice cream or something and be like, hey, y'all, how's training going? I'm not saying get in there and get to sparring, but...
You know what? I think it was that she's a little bit out of her element, and I think I'm a firm believer mixed martial arts is a selfish sport. Sometimes you got to do what you got to do to make sure you're all right, and obviously this meant a lot to her. Maybe it meant more to her losing and not having the opportunity to become a world champion. All these dreams, she's older, she's trying to make her comeback, she's switching weight classes, she's thought she did everything right. She needs that 2 hours. And you know, Sijara, you're in the house all the time with those people, that person that, you know, she's lost to. She wants just a little bit of time by herself. I don't see a problem with her saying that 2 hours. She came to that later practice with, I'm with you, Mike. I take that Sunday off after the fight. I feel like she said she felt like she got hit by a bus. What good is she even going to be to anybody?
No, exactly. She's going to be exhausted physically and mentally. Of course, she's been in the UFC before. You know, she's got a stab here at becoming the world champion. She's failed there. She's away from family. She's missing a child. Right. She's not in an emotionally good place. I think she deserves a little bit of a break. Honestly, I'll be honest, she kind of annoyed me a little bit on that episode, even though she was great when she came in last week. So, but she was right on this. Lauren,
she certainly
I got
wasn't
your
wrong.
Back, girl.
she certainly wasn't wrong.
But she didn't what? Even...
She certainly wasn't wrong.
No.
Yeah.
She didn't even sit in the bed and lick her wounds. She hung out and had lunch and with the girl that just beat her.
Yeah, but that's okay. That's called being a classy sportsman.
So, I rather would have hung
that's
out
That's what
with...
I mean, I'll take Luke out to lunch any day of the week.
Will you?
I won't pay.
Sijara, I have a question for you. Because one of the issues Lauren appeared to have is that she really didn't think that Eddie was great coaching women. And you guys, I'd love to hear your opinions on this, if there is a difference in coaching men or coaching women. But I'm curious how you felt about Eddie as a coach and his style relating to you guys.
I loved Eddie's coaching style. I mean, it was hard-nosed. It was to the point. I liked that he tried to keep us in our element as best that he could. He kept the codes and the coaching relatively simple. I kind of like it. He admitted himself coming in. He's like, I don't know how to work with women. Yeah. And throughout the show, he even said, he was like, I'm just going to try to treat y'all like fighters. And
I kind of struggle to see the difference, though. I mean, you know, maybe I'm ignorant to it, between coaching a man and coaching a woman, because ultimately the techniques are the same thing, right?
Michael, a punch is a punch. That might be the smartest thing you've ever said.
Maybe, you know, you guys are a bit more limber, you're a bit more flexible, you can, you know, maybe wash the dishes after dinner and stuff like
that. Wow, hilarious.
Keep the place nice and clean.
You better be careful. He's looking at you like she's going to stab you.
Listen, this table needs a wipe, so, you know, when we're done here, I expect this place spotless.
Oh, Michael's not going to be walking out of here, I promise you that.
I expect a check then, since guys are the money makers.
Michael, I'm joshing.
But Misha,
before I retract my comments to Michael about being so smart.
Well,
I was going to ask you, Misha, because not only have you been a coach on The Ultimate Fighter for your own season, but you've also come in and helped on an other season. So you have coached men, you have coached women. Have you seen a difference in either how they relate to you when you're coaching, or if there is a difference in trying to get your point across?
No, not really. To be honest, I know statistically women tend to do better with positive reinforcement, okay. But I try to be a positive person anyways. I'm coaching males or females. I just enjoy working with someone who wants to learn. Mm-hmm. Somebody who wants to be there, who's hungry. I don't really distinguish a male or female. We are all fighters at the end of the day. Yeah. We're getting in there and we're fighting for our lives. We're fighting for our dreams. And if somebody wants to get in there and be coached and learn, coachable.
To be fair, I think...
Male or female, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And to be fair, I think what Eddie was talking about, maybe he wasn't overly comfortable. Because as I said, the techniques are the same, as you said as well. But, you know, perhaps being in an environment where it's a full female team, maybe that can be a little intimidating, a little daunting, because he's not, you know, if he's not...
Like
me personally,
sure.
I've never coached a woman. I've never trained with a woman, you know? So maybe he's just a little unfamiliar in that territory,
he
you know?
He probably wasn't sure, but I think he realized real quick
I'm
that
sure by
it's
the
not
end of it,
that
he
much
knew.
Different. You
yeah,
know?
No,
you
absolutely.
You teach someone to throw a right hand, you teach someone to throw a right hand.
Yep, yep.
It's sink or swim. Like, either you cut it or you don't, you know?
You know?
I agree. And honestly, if I had to coach 16 women, I'd be a little intimidated.
What about if you had to coach, if you had to coach 16 men?
Yeah, I mean, I think you get a whole bunch of any one gender in a room. It can be either too much of testosterone and estrogen.
As Michael is finding out right now.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, whoa.
And you're never going to please everyone.
So
no matter what you do,
yeah,
you're
going to
please everyone. When you have a team of eight people, eight different personalities that are all competitors.
Listen, let me just tell you, I can handle eight women at once, all right? Just
on
throwing
that
it out there.
On that note, while Michael floats off to dreamland,
we're talking about training.
We'll see if you can handle three.
Tough. Every Wednesday, right after The Ultimate Fighter at 11 p.m. Eastern on FS1.
Talking about training.